Temporary 5 mile an hour on you at the moment. Waiting track works.
What's the next plan of action for the railway?
I don't know really. Trying to keep on top of what we've got. Because essentially we've got railway sort of 4 miles that way. Or 3 miles that way.
Is the track on it all?
Yeah. But there's one small part that the metal fairy stole many years ago. And then that way, the track's all there to Cabellan.
Yeah, we didn't actually cross on the road.
Yeah.
When I spoke to your colleague there, who said they're making attempts to open it.
The biggest problem we've got is red tape. That's essentially what it is.
Well, it's like the Barnstable and Linton Railway.
Mm.
I mean, they've got the track made.
Yeah.
I think they've got lots of permissions, but it's getting the last.
Yeah.
T's crossed and I's dotted.
Well, we've got the problem, the crossing of the A5, if we go across it on the level, allegedly, it's the only European trunk road with a level crossing. You're told?
I think at the moment the Kent and East Sussex are trying to get permission to cross an A road.
Yeah.
Can't be absolutely sure of that.
But it's more than an A road, this one. It's one of the listed European trunk roads, apparently. So.
Is it Mr. Telford who was the engineer for it?
Yes.
Yeah. It's a pest there.
Yeah. The other road that way, which are also hemmed in by, it's the A483. That's not so much of an issue. I think we can go across that one.
Yeah, because we've got the proper barrier gates and everything.
Everything's all there, from what I understand. And no quote on this as such, but the crossing was never signed off as a level crossing because this railway was on the verge of closing. I mean, it only had like one train every 2 weeks or something, and it never got signed off as a crossing. Now, of course, to sign it off as a crossing, it has to meet different standards. So now, 35 years on.
Like when they relayed the Welsh Highland Railway, and it was relayed to modern standards.
Yeah. Well, I know that railway very well. I was a driver up there. Not anymore. I was.
Was that on the steam?
Steam, yeah. Driver on Stonehouse Brewery and Welsh Highland.
I working for me. His wife was a driver on the Stonehouse.
Okay.
Claire Oaks.
I last 15 years ago. Maybe Jenny Quayle, I think.
Second name was Crow.
Don't know that.
Well, since you may not be driving
there. No.
But I put a camera on one of the engines and probably he's really proactive.
Yeah.
Go on now. Well, a lot of the railways are saying now, any advertising is good advertising.
Yeah. Oh, absolutely. Particularly for us, because we're still very embryonic.
It's tough, isn't it, to get out of that embryonic stage?
Yes.
I mean, I've been around a while now, so I watched the Pacer DMU road from just going across the shop.
Yeah.
I've seen the Welsh Island go for nothing.
Yeah.
And my local railway, Bluebell, it only went all the kings.
Yeah.
It's been a real privilege.
Oh, yeah.
Awesome. So it happens.
Yeah. Well, fingers crossed with this. I mean, I was involved staying on Welsh Island for 20 years. It was only during COVID, really, that I stopped going. Young family, and the days were just too long travelling up there. And
I used to stay in the Millennium Forest or what?
Yes. The
caravan.
Yeah.
Went every year and filmed and photographed the line slowly extended. Yeah, it's really nice to watch it happening.
Yeah.
The Black Hand Gang.
Yeah, well, I loved it. I mean, I walked through the tunnels as a child with my dad.
They're long, aren't they?
Yeah.
Eerie.
And of course, at that point, I never thought for a minute I'd drive a train through it.
Well, what my grandfather used to take through the Everglass Pass, I didn't believe him when he said there used to be a railway.
Well, at that point, it was highly unlikely the railway was even going to be built. Never mind that I'd be driving the engines through it. Yeah, quite incredible. There we go.